Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are perfectly fine and doing your studies at your home. Students, this is Saumitri Yadav, assistant teacher of Lakshmi Prasad Memorial Public School, which is situated in Gola Bazar, Gorakhpur. Students, I am here with a new online video class in which we will discuss chapter number 11, which is pronouns. So, let's start. Read these sentences. Kanika loves playing basketball. She is the captain of the school team. Ritul and Sunit are building a model of the solar system. They are working very hard. Divesh is very fun-loving. All my friends like him. My pet is naughty, yet everyone likes to play with it. So, highlighted words in these sentences are personal pronouns. She and they act as subjects and are subject pronoun, whereas him and it come in place of the objects and are object pronouns. So, students, the highlighted words in these sentences, she, they, him, and it all are personal pronouns, and in these she and they both are subject pronoun and him and it are object pronoun. Okay, now what is personal pronoun? Pronouns that stand for the names of people and things are called personal pronouns. What are subject pronouns? Personal pronouns that act as the subject in a sentence are called subject pronouns. Personal pronouns that come in place of the object in a sentence are called object pronoun. So, students, in this chapter we have read about personal pronoun, subject pronoun and object pronoun. Now, people or things that receive the action of the verb are called the object of the verb. Now, students, you have given a table to learn about personal pronoun. So, there are three persons: first person, second person and third person. Next column is given about the subject pronouns which we will use for these persons. Third column is about object pronoun. So students, first person is I and we. I in singular and we in plural. And object pronoun of I is me and we is us. Now second person, you. Object pronoun of you is also you. Third person, he, she, it, they. And object pronoun of he is him, she is her, they is them. Once again, the object pronoun of I is me, object pronoun of we is us, and object pronoun of you is you, object pronoun of he is him, she is her, it is it, they is them. Now next, read these sentences. This is my cupboard. These are Rajni's book. Those are my dresses. That is my uncle's house. The highlighted words in these sentences points to nouns, cupboards, books, dresses, etc. They are demonstrative pronouns. This, these, those and that. All these are demonstrative pronouns. Now what are demonstrative pronouns? The pronouns that point to the objects to which they refer are called demonstrative pronoun. This refer to cupboard. These refer to books. Those refer to dresses. That refers to house. So pronouns that point to the object to which they refer are called demonstrative pronouns. Now notes is given in the side. Pronoun of the first person denote the person speaking. Students, I am speaking, so I am first person. Pronoun of the second person denote the person spoken to. Students, I am speaking to you. आप लोगों से मैं बात कर रही हूँ. It means you all are second person. Persons of the third pronouns of the third person refer to the person or thing that we are talking about. We are talking about the third person, so these are called third person. Now next is, read these sentences. Please give this ruler to Preeti. It's hers. This backpack is yours. That one is mine. The red car is his. The bigger chair is ours. Highlighted words in these sentences show possession or belongings. They are possessive pronouns. So what is possessive pronoun? The pronouns that are used to indicate that something belongs to someone are called possessive pronoun. Now, study this table to learn something possessive pronoun. First person, for first person we will use mine. For we will use mine possessive pronoun. For we will use ours possessive pronoun. Second person is you, and we will use yours both for singular and as well as plural. Third person, for he we will use his possessive pronoun. For she we will use hers possessive pronoun. For it we will use its possessive pronoun. Now for they we will use theirs possessive pronoun. I hope this is clear. Now come to the last point. Read these sentences. Who sent you that parcel? What would you like to eat for dessert? Which is your favorite subject? What is the use of crying over spilt milk? So the highlighted words in these sentences are used to ask questions. These are interrogative pronoun. So what are interrogative pronoun? The pronouns that are used to ask questions are called interrogative pronoun. Now let's revise this chapter once again. So students, in this chapter I have told you about the personal pronoun, subject pronoun, object pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, possessive pronoun and interrogative pronoun. I have already told you about the three persons in pronoun. So what is personal pronoun? Pronouns that stand for the names of people and things are called personal pronoun. What is subject pronoun? Personal pronouns that act as subject in a sentence are called subject pronoun. What is object pronoun? Personal pronoun that comes in place of the object in a sentence are called object pronoun. Next, what is first person? Pronoun of the first person denotes the person speaking. What is second person? Pronouns of the second person denote the person spoken to. What is third person? Pronouns of the third person refer to the person or thing that we are talking about. Now what is demonstrative pronoun? The pronouns that point to the objects to which they refer are called demonstrative pronoun. What is possessive pronoun? The pronouns that are used to indicate that something belongs to someone are called possessive pronouns. What is interrogative pronoun? The pronouns that are used to ask questions are called interrogative pronoun. So that's it for today, students. You will revise this chapter at your home, and also you will do all the exercise of chapter number 11 in your book. We will meet in next video with a new exercise. Thank you, everyone.